We're going to go, we're going to speak on line one, to Raylene Guzny. And Raylene Guzny is joining us. She's the acting director of Smokers Helpline, Newfoundland Labrador. Welcome to the show, Raylene. How are you today?
Good, thanks. How are you?
Very well, thanks. I noticed today on Twitter your organization was informing those of us who follow on Twitter that there is an issue connected with smokers or quitting smoking and mental health. And given that it is Mental Health Week from May 5th to 11th, I thought it would be very interesting to hear a little bit more, because for those of you who are not on Twitter, there are very small bursts of information where you go digging for a bit more. But hey, what better way to find out more information than to actually have a conversation? So, Raylene, could you please tell us what's on the go? First of all, a little bit about Smokers Helpline, Newfoundland Labrador, and what's the connection?
Yeah, well, the Smokers Helpline is a free service offered to the residents of Newfoundland and Labrador, and we have a few different things that we can offer people who are trying to quit smoking, people who may have recently quit and are trying to stay smoke-free, as well as family and friends with who know people who smoke, health professionals, teachers and students, and even workplaces. So we do offer telephone counseling as well as email counseling to people who are hoping to quit smoking or to maintain being smoke-free. We have self-help materials that we can send out. We also have our website, which is www.smokershelp.net. And we do have a group program, and that's actually the second session of that is coming up this Friday at Sobeys on Merrymeeting Road in their community room at 12 noon. So if anyone is interested in seeing what that's about, they can certainly check it out.
Well, that's great. I know that I've been to that website many times, the smokershelp.net. It's very informative. There's lots of tools there for those who want to quit, or those I thought that this is a great thing that you have, is helping someone else quit. Now, I guess you see this more along the lines where children want to help their parents or grandparents quit, but is there a reversal of do you see? Now, maybe you can help me out here, Raylene. Are there the demographic for those who still smoke, is it a younger demographic, or are we looking at a more of a still an older generation, which just can't give it up?
The largest group, of course, there is still 20% of the population in Newfoundland and Labrador who smoke. Mm-hmm. The largest percentage would fall in the age group from 25 to 44, but we do still see in smoking rates in the younger population, as well as the older age groups as well. So there really is, you know, it spans the generations for sure.
You said, your organization put this out on Twitter, quitting smoking improves mood and mental health, similar to taking an antidepressant drug. That's a pretty bold statement. What exactly, what do you mean by that? I mean, are you saying that quitting smoking is equivalent to being on an antidepressant, or is it just a one-time buzz? I know that, you know, when I quit smoking many times, it the withdrawal is well, it's certainly like a drug, but it's not exactly a good happy euphoric feeling. You almost feel like your brain is starving of something.
Yeah, for sure. So that statement was actually in reference to a paper that was published in the British Medical Journal just recently. And so they did a study that looked at a variety of people with that had mental illness, people without mental illness, and they saw that among everyone, those who quit smoking did see reduced depression, anxiety, and stress, along with improved positive mood and quality of life compared to those who continue to smoke. So that's really where that came from. Of course, as you mentioned, the withdrawal symptoms, that is very common. So, you know, in those first 2, 3, maybe even 4 weeks, it does differ for different people. There will be those withdrawal symptoms. So there may be that increased anxiety. But of course, with smoking, a lot of the times people do say, oh, it improves my mood, things like that. But it really only improves the mood while they're fighting that nicotine withdrawal.
Sure.
And then, you know, that returns once the nicotine levels drop again. And that's when you see people going for that second cigarette.
So if I'm sitting at home right now and I'm listening to you and I, you know, I'm looking across the room and I see, I don't know, could be someone else in my family or group of friends who's I don't know, smells like a little bit of resin from the nicotine action. What would you tell me would be the best way to approach and bring them towards considering calling the Smokers Helpline? What is the best way that those who want to help others quit, what is the best approach?
It differs for everybody, but in most cases, I can say that, nagging doesn't work. People already know about a lot of the negative health consequences and the smell on the clothes and the hair. They know all about those negatives, so it's really nice to focus on the positives. Just within 20 minutes of the last cigarette, your blood pressure drops back to normal, your heart rate returns to normal, and then as soon as 48 hours, your food and begins to smell and taste better.
That's a big one for me. I mean, I remember relearning the taste of food was always just fantastic. Raylene, lastly, before we go, just give us a shout-out for the Smokers Helpline phone number, because you are a helpline before you were a website. So what is it?
Exactly, yeah. So our phone number is 1-800-363-5864. And we are open Monday to Thursday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. and 9 to 5 on Fridays.
And in between those times when you're unavailable, I guess we just have to look towards our friends for help. And Raylene Guzny, that's great, because I think that certainly builds community. Thanks for joining us tonight, telling us a little bit about Smokers Helpline. And you're right, you do feel better when you stop.
Excellent.
Have a great night.
Thanks so much.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Feel good story. And if you're trying to quit, don't forget, 1-800-363-5864.